Red Mountain, here we are. This is our final announcements that will be played for our school year. And so we encourage you to stay and watch. This is going to be a little bit of a longer episode. We're going to be playing a show. And this is my last time ever being on the announcements. So, you know, Red Mountain, I might cry, but that's okay. Anyways, kicking off the show, we have cross country. So let's run right into this video.
I got into cross country. I was in cross country in junior high, and then I moved from New Mexico here, and I came and just joined the team, and I was able to compete that year, and it was a lot of fun. My expectation for this season is to qualify for state, either by the team or individually, and then I want to get as high as I can in that state meet to try to compete against other schools in the area.
I kind of expect us to qualify for state. It's going to be a tough road because we lost a lot of our good guys last year, but we can definitely still do it, still qualify for state.
I'm trying to break 17 in the 5K, and then going into track, I'm going to try to get 155 for the 800.
My biggest goal is just to PR. I want to get better than I was last year, and for the team, I'm really looking forward to city. I hope we win it this year and go to state, and I'm really looking forward to the pasta parties before every race. Those are really fun.
My goals for the season are to go to state, and I'm really looking forward to getting to know the new team members and be able to bond with them.
My jokes still have not gotten any better, but what has gotten better is our quality, as you can tell by the last video, I'm hoping. Anyways, we have swim and dive, so I guess you could say we could dive right into this video.
In the off season, I swim club, so I swim morning and afternoon, Monday through Friday, and then Saturday mornings, and that's 2 hours each, so I'm still swimming in the off season. This season, I'm hoping to make top two, maybe three, or top three in state, and in the 50 and the 100 free, and then hopefully win state for the 4x50 relay and get top three in the 4x1.
I think the team is going to do really well. We have a lot more new kids this year, and we have a lot of talented swimmers, and I think our expectations should be high.
How I feel like the team is going to do this year is absolutely amazing. We do have one of the strongest teams in Arizona at the moment for diving. So it's all about keeping our attitudes up, our grades up, and just keep working away every day. This year, I'm hoping to take home the state title. There's a lot of good competition out there, but last year I was very, very close, and all the seniors graduated, so I got a good shot. The way I got into diving was through gymnastics. I did gymnastics for about 8-ish years, and then my body started breaking, and I was like, I need to change. So the flipping from the gymnastics and the flipping from dive really goes hand in hand.
To do this one last time on the announcements because, you know, this has some sentimental. Mikey!
Oh!
He caught me. Don't worry.
That was more forward than up, man.
I wonder if we're gonna add a hole in the green screen.
No holes in the green screen. Anyways, making a loud introduction, let's have orchestra come on.
What actually got me interested in orchestra was my sister. So at the time she was playing the violin, so once like fourth grade came around, I decided to pick the cello because I wanted to be different from her. But she really inspired me to go into music. So what I like about orchestra is simply how like close everyone can get with each other. Like, it's like a class where you can relax but still be serious in, and plus you're able to express yourself through your playing.
I started orchestra in fifth grade at my elementary school, and my parents had a violin from my grandfather, so they're like, you're gonna play violin now, so I joined orchestra. I love orchestra. One, it gives a sense of community, a shared interest that a lot of people can bond over, and you get to make beautiful music and really just enjoy it and what you do.
up next, we have another sport, which is our track team, and especially our track team that just won our Arizona Open State Championship 1A through 6A. Now, congratulations to this track team. You guys worked extremely hard this year. I know I saw all of you guys out at Rampage and the blazing heat, so great job to you guys, and let's play this next video. You guys are the Open State champions. Anyways, moving forward, we're gonna relive prom, and for those freshmen who did not get to see what prom was like, here's something to look forward to.
I'm Alexander Estrada.
I'm Sienna Cavallo.
I'm excited for the awesome fairy tale Shrek theme.
And I'm excited to see people that I haven't in a long time because it's been like a year since I've gone to Red Mountain.
We went and took pictures in some place in Gilbert.
And then we ate at Olive Garden. Those that brushes my clutches get put on crutches, get smoked like touches from the master.
Shake, 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 shake it out, I shake it out, I never miss a beat. I'm give it up one more time for John Cotler and Catherine.
Navy.
I'm Mom Michael. We went to Osaka with a bunch of friends, 11-person party.
I'd just say we're excited to have a good time.
We're gonna go to main event and or our friend's house.
I am the student council advisor, but I'm a co-advisor. I don't do this alone. Mrs. English is also an advisor with me. My favorite part about prom is planning it. The best part about the actual event tonight is the wristbands. I'm so excited that we have the wristbands. I wanted to do something super fun and neat and cool, and I saw that Taylor Swift had them. And so I called up my DJ and I said, hey, can we get those wristbands that Taylor Swift has? He said, let me call you back. He made a couple of phone calls and we were able to get them. So that has been my most favorite part, to see these and to see the floor and to see everybody jumping and the lights going with the music has been really, really fun. I couldn't ask for anything better. Thank you.
Prom feels like it was yesterday, even though it was a few weeks ago. Also, props on the food, it was great. Now, moving forward, we want to see what doesn't go in the announcements. I know you guys have probably wondered for a good time of how we do it and what goes into the efforts. So, we'll show you guys.
Okay.
Tell a few stories that should be passed down.
All right, now, okay, so for any future RMTV members that stumble upon this, I deeply apologize.
Good morning, Red Mountain. I'm King Emperor of the World, Robert. Here are my bodyguards, and here are your announcements today for Thursday.
Per hour, with a humidity of 16%. And a UV index of 9. Now, it'll also be sunny.
Good afternoon. Even my coffee needs coffee, Red Mountain. Today is Friday, December 11th, 2021.
All right, Red Mountain, this is your last announcement of the year. And now we're going to do our final send-off, whatever you want to call this. But we're going to look at some of the seniors that have helped us over the last 4 years, starting with Max Vukun, which is our EP in there. Or Vocone, whatever his last name is. Then we have Robert, our main anchor, a big help. Austin, one of our videographers and editors. And then we have Eli, one of our technical directors. And then we have Brennan, one of the terrible weather guy.
Whoa.
And I'm sorry, has to be said. Has to be said. I'm sorry, has to be said. Okay, anyways. It's been one heck of a year with you guys, and I can't wait to, you know, end this finally. So thank you for watching the announcements as little as you did, and we know it. So goodbye, Red Mountain.
You're doing okay.
Bye, Red Mountain.
Bye, Red Mountain.
Bye.
You really are a terrible speaker. I don't even know why we do.
I don't know why.